Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to do a quick run through of how to install a small mod using the OpenIV tool. For those who are not familiar with that, it enables you to access the, I'm going to call them the deep code game files. In this instance, it'll be for Grand Theft Auto 5. The mod we shall be installing is Enhanced Explosions mod. So OpenIV, you can get it from GTA5mods.com, tools section, be in there. And the tool looks like, let me open it up, excuse my messy desktop. When you first run it up, you get a selection of games. You need to pick your flavour of game, in this case Grand Theft Auto 5 running on Windows. Click on that. It automatically checks for updates when it, there we go, that's a little bit better. Automatically checks for updates and make that massive for you. What you need to do is you need to point, when you first load OpenIV, you need to point it at your GTA 5, in this case, executable folder, which, for those who don't know, I did do a brief video on it, but I'll just pop up my C drive here. This is a Steam copy. I'm guessing if you're running the non-Steam copy, it'll just be sat in your programs files. As this is Steam, scroll down to Steam. It's in fact in the x86 directory. So anyway, we'll scroll back down to Steam. There we go. Steam. And then you want Steam apps. And then you want common at the top. And it'll be sat inside here. As you can see, mine's not in there because I've got it on a different drive. So it'll, if you imagine common, it'll just look like that, really. So anyway, you open it up, you've got this, and you can navigate, basically, your folders and so on and so forth. Basically, a couple of things to remember. One, whilst you're floating around and faffing about and opening these things and stuff like that, you can't actually do any damage as it is when you first run the program. In order to do any damage, you have to edit. You have to enter edit mode up here in the top right-hand corner. You have to click on that, and it'll obviously give you a warning dialogue. Click yes. So now, if you fiddle about with stuff, it could potentially break your game. So, just good practice is always keep edit mode off unless you are 100% certain and you've backed up. You can back up files and stuff outside of edit mode, I do believe. So the file we're going to be installing at the explosions mod sits in the, I believe in here, in update. Click on update, we've got update RPF. Click on that, and it is in common, I believe. Common, data, effect. There's the explosions like that, save content export will possibly do it, but I prefer the drag and drop method. I like to see it happening, so we shall do that. I'll right click and drag it across, copy here, there we go, to the zip file. We'll tell you what, first thing we'll do, we'll enter it edit mode. Right, so we're live now within the OpenIV environment. Navigate to our modified file. Most mod creators will include the original file or an unmodified vanilla file, as it says here. So any files that you will be modifying, often there'll be a backup copy within the mod zip file. But it's kind of nice practice just to back up the mod yourself. So basically we'll just drag and drop like that. Simples. Come out of edit mode again just to be safe. And we shall shut it down. And that is it. Job done. There's no saving or anything like you'll see numerous warning dialog boxes. Yeah, it's as simple as that really. Can be a little daunting, I suppose, if you're not used to it. I'm not used to it. But check it out. Like I say, though, be careful. Stay out of edit mode unless you're 100% sure and confident about what you're doing. And the main thing is backup. So if something goes wrong, you can quite easily undo it. Anyway, hopefully that was informative, not too fast or too slow. So the two main things to remember are, one, backup, backup, backup. That's a key thing. So if you're going to modify anything, backup. You could, I suppose, backup your entire, for example, the update RPF file. There's a belt and brakes as measure, but it's quite big. So perhaps don't want to do that. And also, stay out of edit mode unless you are confident you know what you're doing, what you're replacing. And like I say, you're confident you've got that backup in a safe place. So you can always revert any issues that may or may not develop. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, hit the like button if this was informative or helpful in any way. And drive safe, as they say. We'll catch you later. Cheers.